Hi everyone, I'm Elaine and I'm so glad you could join me today. Hey, I've got a question for you. In your opinion, what is the yuckiest animal alive? In my opinion, the yuckiest animal alive is the blobfish. It looks so slimy. Slimy things kind of freak me out, but you know, they kind of do look sad, like they need a hug. Maybe they're just shiny and not slimy. If I ever meet a blobfish, maybe I'll have enough courage to hug it. How about you? What do you think is the yuckiest animal alive? Ugh, that sounds kind of yucky. Anyway, we'll revisit some of other yucky animals later in our story. But for now, let's take a look at our memory verse. Listen as I read it aloud, or you can read it along with me. The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 28. Great job, everyone. And today's big God story, we learn that God was sad for his people because they were slaves in Egypt. So he appeared to a man named Moses. Do you know how God appeared to Moses? That's right. God spoke to Moses from a burning bush. God told Moses his name and that he was going to free his people, the Israelites, from slavery in Egypt so they could worship the one true God. God shared his name with Moses. Do you know what name God shared with Moses? God told Moses that his name is I Am Who I Am. This name is important because it's the name God used when he spoke to Abraham and made a big God promise called a covenant promise with him. It's also important because I am means God is real, compared to the Egyptian gods that weren't real. God is the Lord, and he rules over everything. Now, what do you think Pharaoh thought about God's people calling God the one true God, and the Egyptian gods were considered not real? Well, Pharaoh actually thought he himself was a god. He thought that no one was going to make him free the Israelite slaves. But by refusing to let the Israelites go, Pharaoh was basically challenging God to fight. Do you think there's anyone or anything like God? There is no one like God. He is holy. He alone is worthy of our worship. And he alone is Lord. Now, obviously, God would win any fight in an instant, but God wanted to prove to the Israelites and to the Egyptian that he alone is Lord. So God decided to send many miraculous signs. In fact, God sent 10 plagues to prove that no one and nothing else is like him. He is Lord. Now, with the first plague, God turned the Nile River into blood. Ugh. The Nile is one of the longest rivers in the world, and the Egyptians worshipped it. This was the first sign God gave to show that he alone is Lord. But this did not convince Pharaoh to let God's people go to worship him. So once again, Moses said to Pharaoh, "This is what the Lord says, let my people go so that they may worship me." Of course, Pharaoh said no. In response, God sent yet another plague. This time he sent frogs. Frogs climbed out of the river and went everywhere. Can you imagine having frogs in your bed, in your shoes, in your cereal bowl, or even up your pant legs? Everywhere? That's what it was like. So gross. Every time Pharaoh said no to releasing God's people, God sent yet another plague to show his power over any fake Egyptian god. God sent gnats and flies that ruined the land. He sent a plague that killed the Egyptians' animals and a plague that gave them ugly big sores all over their body. God also proved he controls the weather by sending a terrible hailstorm. Then he sent a plague of locusts that covered all the ground until it was black. Now, if you have your Bible with you, let's turn to Exodus chapter 10, verse 15. Or you can read along with me. They covered all the ground until it was black. They devoured all that was left after the hail. Everything was growing in the fields and the fruit on the trees. Nothing green remained on the tree or plant in all the land of Egypt. Even though all of these plagues hurt the Egyptians' land, their animals, their bodies, and their crops, Pharaoh would not let God's people go. The Bible goes on to say in verses 22 and 23, "So Moses stretched out his hands towards the sky, and total darkness covered all Egypt for 3 days. No one could see anyone else or move about for 3 days. Yet all of the Israelites had light in the places where they lived. Even so, Pharaoh still wouldn't let God's people go. Again, he said no. And this time, he told Moses to never come before him again, or he would have Moses killed. God had one plague left, and we'll hear about that plague next week. It was the most terrible one yet. It's the one that convinced Pharaoh to let God's people go. Now, you might be wondering why God did all of these things. God did all of these things because he wanted his name to be proclaimed and all his power to be seen across the world. And today, God is still the Lord, the one who hears our cries and the one who loves us, the one who delivers us, the one who reigns over everything. Which brings us to our ponder point for today. Say it as loud as you can with me. Ready? One, two, three. God is the Lord. Well, that concludes our big God story for today. It was so great to hang out with you and learn more about our amazing God. I'll see you next week.